Hi everyone, hope you're doing well from whenever you're watching this channel, depending on the time zone. Now, Kimani Ngunjiri is one man who has made it clear that he's going to stand with the Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua and condemn everyone who's trying to undermine him within the UDA party and the Kenya Kwanza arrangement. With that, we have seen something that Rigathi Gachagua is pushing for, and to draw the line between him and William Ruto, Gachagua went on to resurrect the narrative about one man, one vote, one shilling. That is what they're pushing for. You look at that and you see a lot of difference between Gachagua and William Ruto. Ruto is purely against one man, one vote, one shilling. From his side, we have individuals who are now coming up with something that they're also pushing for, which is actually against the other one. For them, it is one man, one vote, one shilling, and you also add 1 kilometer. So landmass is also coming to play. With all this, we are seeing Kimani Ngunjiri contradicting himself. First of all, in 2021, and in 2020 there, when Raila Odinga together with Uhuru Kenyatta, they were pushing for the one man, one vote, one shilling through BBI. They were supposed to add more constituencies. They were supposed to put more resources where there is more people. But there is a position both Gachagua and Kimani Ngunjiri took. Right now, it is opposite. So if you listen to what he is saying today, then what he said some time back, you find a contradiction, and from there, you have to draw the line and understand this kind of position that we are having. So first of all, listen to what he's pushing for today, and I'll take you to another video on what he was standing for during that time.
Ile Raila Odinga amekuwa akipigania, sasa tumeanza kuiona. Hatukuwa tukiona. Ile Raila Odinga alikuwa anapigania, tunaiona sasa. Akisema mkate is not being shared,
Equally.
It's the same thing we are seeing watu ya milima na sehemu zingine kwa sababu sio milima peke yake. The bread is not being shared.
Actually, the narrative here that they want to sell to Mount Kenya is that of one man, one vote, one shilling. Equality in terms of distribution of resources against the population. But some time back, Kimani Ngunjiri referred to this move as a snake. And a snake is poisonous. Therefore, the only thing they could do to the snake is to kill the snake. Therefore, Kimani Ngunjiri made a joke, he even acted drama on BBI in reference to as a snake and killing the snake. So, literally, Kimani Ngunjiri and other people that are pushing for one man, one vote, one shilling, at one point killed that idea.
Raila Odinga amesema nyoka. BBI ni nyoka. Na nyoka imetokea. We are very scared with the snake. Sumu ya nyoka ni mbaya sana. Na kama namna hiyo, mimi nataka tushikane wote. Hiyo Raila amesema ni nyoka. Nyoka, we must defend ourselves. Na nitaanza, kama ni nyoka, I'm ready. Kugonga nyoka kichwa, irudi kwa shimo. Raila Odinga alisema, ni nyoka, na itatuuma. Na hii nyoka, we are ready. Tutapigana na hii nyoka.
Ua nyoka.
Tutaua nyoka na hii miti, baka irudi kwa kipango yake. Ni mudomo yake, ni maneno yake, ambaye ametoa yeye mwenyewe. We are talking and responding with what you have said. Wana Kenya, is it BBI or the snake? Na tunajua bila amefanyia kijana yetu, he can only do that to us with the snake. Tunajua mikutano mingi sana inazungumuzwa, unakuta nyoka imetokea katikati ya mikutano. So, hata kwa mikutano na waomba Kenyans, wakati munafanya mikutano, angalia nyoka, isikuwe around hapo. Kwa sababu itaweza kujua ni ile nyoka ya Raila Odinga amesema yeye mwenyewe. We shall be responding to you with your words. The words you are putting, we are responding with them. Nyoka! Uwe nyoka! Itatuma! Uwe nyoka!
Now, the whole issue on this fight line, as far as this video is concerned, is looking at the history of these leaders in terms of what they were supporting and what they're standing for as of now. Are they leaders that we can trust? Are these leaders that Mount Kenya region should be believing in, supporting, and standing with? That is the big question we are looking to. But before we go deep into that, just a quick request for those who are watching and you are not yet subscribed, please consider subscribing to our channel. Subscribe, thank you so much. And again, to all our viewers, please give this video a thumbs up. Thank you so much, and back to this discussion. Now, just one question that Kimani Ngunjiri and those that he's supporting should be answering. What has changed between 2021 and now 2024? In 2024, he's saying that they are now seeing what Raila was pushing for. And Raila was right. But in 2021, they were seeing all the problems in what Raila Odinga was pushing for. So definitely, they made Raila Odinga their enemy. Without looking at the content which Raila Odinga was carrying, the policy that he was standing for, the manifesto he was carrying for this country, for them it was all about demonizing Raila Odinga. Such kind of leaders who use all the rest of their time, a whole year opposing Raila Odinga, then they come and say that, oh, Raila was right and we were wrong. How do you continue to trust such leaders? Today, because they want to bring a discussion that is contrary to what Ruto is pushing for, due to their own difference that have emerged in UDA, they now justify what Raila Odinga was pushing for to be right. The same people, when Raila Odinga was advocating for devolution, that was fine 2010, 2009, when they were pushing for the new constitution. Raila advocated for devolution, county governments. We were either supposed to have 8 strong devolution units, or you break down to district 47. They said Raila Odinga is pushing for majimboism, and that means you are bringing tribal politics. That is tribalism. They opposed. But Raila, by the grace of God, he got people who could believe in his manifesto. There were a lot of changes that were done even, because we were supposed to have upper house and lower house, whereby the Senate will be the upper house and the most powerful house where decisions are made. Then he again back in Kuchini. Just like UK. But there was give and take so that to balance, make sure that the devolution issue is passing. Well, it's even empire size. People are enjoying devolution despite the fact that there is not enough money given to counties. There is something you can smile at on the devolution on the county level. But they said ni mbaya kwa sababu yule ambaye alileta ni mtu hawakuwa wanamtaka. So those who want to believe in Kimani Ngunjiri, Rigathi Gachagua, there is one question they have to ask themselves. Are these leaders genuine? Can their word be trusted? Can their word become their bond? If the answer is no, then just know that these leaders have come together to fight for their own political interest, but not for the people's interest. They don't speak for you. They don't fight for you. They don't have any agenda for you. The agenda and only sole agenda they have is political interest for their own stomach. If Gachagua would not have his own difference with William Ruto, there is no way Gachagua would come and start the agenda one man, one vote, one shilling. All they're talking about is just lip service. It's a lip agenda. But they don't mean it. There is an issue that Gachagua and Ruto have disagreed. But they are using this issue of one man, one vote, and one shilling and other things just to make sure that as they, you know, push each other, they bring in another agenda that they can use to create another narrative going forward. How are we doing? Because I'm not talking about your pesa or vitu vingine. But now it is coming to public that someone is pushing for the issue of equality in terms of distribution of resources against the population. But he opposed it. Kimani Ujiri referred to it as a snake. They fought the snake. Wakachukua paka mipini ya majembe. Wakasema wanapiga nyoka. Wakafanya sarakasi. Wakafanya hujuma. Ikakuwa ni drama. Just to make sure that they are planting a sense of political direction, which was called what they're pushing among the masses. So you go to Mount Kenya Sazikine, ni vizuri wenyeji wa waangalia vizuri. Hata huyo Martha Karua. Sometimes we better say the truth. She opposed BBI. Liene pewa kotini, akasema ni mbaya. I don't know saizi akiulizo mambo ya one man, one vote, one shilling, anaweza sema ni. But she opposed it. So kabla mtu akuja kuambia hii kitu tuliona ni mbaya saizi tumeona ni mzuri. Huyo ni mkora. Kimani Ngunjiri has been brought by Rigathi Gachagua to work for him, to speak for him, to politically push an agenda to defend Gachagua. But he does not really actually come out as a pro-people leader who want to speak for the people and push for something that is, you know, going to help the people on the ground. They opposed the good thing that BBI was carrying just because they had William Ruto. Today, William Ruto amewaruka, wameanza kurudi kule. Ni sawa na kuanza kukula matapiko. You vomit, then you want to eat your vomit. It doesn't make sense. So these leaders are just people who are into wale watu naitanga brokers. They are brokers. Kimani Ngunjiri is proving to be a broker. Gachagua is a broker. And the entire team, they are brokers. Waliuza their own region kwa siasa za 2022. Waliwauza tu kwa sababu ya mkata na tumbo zao. They opposed one man, one vote, one shilling. So bringing such a discussion back, I think it will not see the light of the day. So treat Kimani Ngunjiri's position as of today as a political statement. Simple. Lakini hawa si watu wakufuata mkisema kwamba mko na viongozi. Hapana. Look for leaders who are going actually to stand with you, defend you, lead in a pushing for people's interest, but not their own stomach. So for that reason, I dismiss Kimani Ngunjiri, I dismiss Gachagua, and I dismiss anyone who had to purport today that he's standing with what was in the BBI. Ni heri, mtu kama Jeremiah Kioni akuja sema maneno ya Kimani Ngunjiri anasema saizi. At least, we can give a iota of trust to Jeremiah Kioni. Lakini huyu, a big no.